Hi, and thank you for joining me on my art studio makeover. This is the before and the after. And during this past couple of months, I was so busy that I didn't really pay attention to what was going on in my studio until one day I walked in and I'm like, oh my God, it is atrocious. Hi everyone, it's Erlene of Erlene Garcia Art. And I'm a little embarrassed to show you the big mess that I got myself into. So after searching the internet for some really cool shelves, I came across these, and these were at Target for $75 each. They're supposed to be, look, that's the office. They're supposed to be for the kitchen, but I decided to use them in my office, and I was so busy making masks that this is what happened. My art studio snowballed into a whole bunch of little snowballs. So this is so embarrassing for me to show you, but this is the life of an artist. As some of you know, I do design authentic American Indian beadwork and jewelry and smudge kits and greeting cards. And then all of a sudden, look what happened. So now it's time to turn this hot mess into my art studio. Again, so I'm going to clear everything out and take it in my bedroom. And those are my dogs, Foxy and Thunder Bear. She hates to be photographed. I'm going to put everything in here temporarily while I think of how I want to. Whoa, look at that. Looks like I should be on a different show. So I'm going to put everything in here, so I have to take it all out so I can start fresh and yikes, and see what kind of mess this is. I can't believe this. Oh my God. Now that I'm looking back at it, what the heck? So yikes, I even had to put it in my dining room, and my dining room kind of turned into a mess. I'll probably have to put that on a different video and make another video of a makeover of the dining room. Anyway, let's get back to the office. So I cleared everything out, and this morning I watched a video really quick on how to build these metal shelves that I purchased at Target, and they were actually really easy. This is a second bedroom in our apartment, and it's just an average size of your average bedroom with not a great view outside, but who cares about that? And obviously, I cannot paint the walls, but that's okay because I'm going to cover it with pictures of Marilyn Monroe. So let's see what it looks like now. So as you remember, you would walk into a big, giant mess. But now, let's see the before. Ugh, that makes me want to gag. And look at the after. Now that's a still shot, so I'm just going to show you now. This is so awesome. The thing is that was really important to me is that I have all of my beads together. And then I have all of my stamping stuff. Yikes! That was a shocker right there. That's when everything was just chaotic. But now look, isn't that beautiful and more soothing? And these shelves are pretty tall, like 74 inches. So it houses a lot. That's my old bookshelf. And now look, everything seems so much more organized. I do need to do a little bit of fine tuning and probably purchase some more boxes that are all the same style, and then pull out my label maker and make some fresh labels for my items. And my little collections kind of stand on their own, not in the way of my supplies. So let's take a look and see what they are. I love little rusty elements. Look at this old-fashioned lock. My mom had it in her stuff, and I grabbed it. And some of my old artwork, just a little recycled tin. So let's continue. And these are all of the beads. And what was important to me is that I keep my bead books with my beads. And then look what I decided to turn into a tool holder. It's one of those pamphlet holders. And I find it so easy to work with. And then these are my specialty beads. Actually, all of my beads are specialty beads, but it is now so much more organized, and I can just turn and grab and I don't have to get up from my desk and walk across the room and have beads on that side and beads on this side. Now everything is all together. And I don't know if you've seen one of my other videos when I first filmed my room, but now I'm really, really happy with it this time. I do like to change it about every 3 or 4 months. So that's just the way my mind works. I feel like, oh, I gotta change it. So, and I do like to collect vintage beads as well. I scour flea markets and junk stores and antique stores just to find the vintage beads because a lot of my customers really appreciate having one-of-a-kind jewelry. So when you incorporate those, it just makes it more special. So let's take a look. Oh, wow, my desk looks amazing. Oh, look at that. Yikes. Okay, so this is after. This is all of my watercolors and my stamps. Yikes, look at that desk. I told you it was a little embarrassing, but now that it's clean and all fresh, it's going to stay this way. And it seems like it even looks bigger. So this white cabinet that I have, I use it to put my TV on because I like to have my TV up high because it's out of the way. And in the white cabinet, I before was keeping just a, God knows, look at that. Oh, that's a crazy mess there. I had files and then I had feathers and God knows what the heck is in there. Oh God, I hope a bat doesn't fly out. Oh my. Anyway, I need to get some new baskets, but these will work for now. These came from the 99 cent store and I have my ribbons in there and I have a lot of fun ribbons because during this time we were not allowed in the fabric store, so I had to use what I had on hand. And I also had ordered some ribbons. I couldn't find fabric anywhere, so I just took whatever fabric I had and enhanced the fabric with the ribbon. And this will be another video if you guys want to learn how to make that. But I have a ton of beautiful ribbon, and this is a sample of one of the masks. There's it. I just like to do things that are a little bit different. And of course, I think out of the box, there's some patches on the mask there. And I just have a ton of ribbon and embroidery floss and buttons and pins. So when you are creating a mask, use what you have on hand and it'll come out and it'll look awesome. Look at that. I use two different color bows. And it just really complements that fun little mask. Now, this is a little old-fashioned table that I bought at the Goodwill for like 15 bucks, and I knew it would be perfect for my sewing machine. And underneath the sewing machine is where I keep some of my specialty fabric. And like this Marilyn Monroe fabric is beautiful. So when you guys have a chance, go on my Etsy and look at the mask. So let's continue. And this is on the ledge, which I noticed I left a piece of double stick tape there. But look at that shelf. Now, you can make those shelves into a couple of different heights, I learned on the internet. So there was something. And then I try to keep like my fashion books separate from my other books, and I have like a wild collection of books because I do a lot of metaphysical work. I like to know what I'm talking about, and I also have a collection of tarot cards, and I do read tarot cards since the age of 14, which was like 100 years ago, but I have more cards than that. That'll be another video. I'd like to share those and maybe have my brother come in. He has a YouTube channel also, and he does some cool stuff. So these are the witchy books that I have, and I also make witch kits. So inside this bin with the bee, I have all of my special resins and herbs and things that I incorporate into the little travel kits that I do. And you know, I take this very seriously, and I want to make sure that everything is done correctly. And those are some of the fun items I sell out on these all the time. I do have a video on how to make it if you want to make one for yourself. And then being an Indian, I just love signs and symbols because it's just the world speaking to me. And I'm sure that a lot of you have had something like a great experience happen to you as well with a sign or a symbol. So these are some of my stones, and I love those. I just love it all. I mean, I just have my hands in everything and anything, just, you know, creating and learning constantly and also teaching. And I feel that I just want to share my talent with the world. And so let's continue to look inside some of these bins. And as you notice, I try to keep the books with the art supply. Therefore, I'm not like searching through my whole library trying to find, you know, my soap book for my soaps. So I do want to start making soaps. I've bought all of the supplies. I have so many cool molds. And I'm going to be making incense. And of course, I will film it and share it with you. So that's my fun glitter. I like to recycle the honey bear containers and put my glitter in it because everybody needs glitter. I don't know why, I just do. So I'm not gonna take all the feathers out of the box. I think we kind of know what feathers look like. But on my incense, I don't know if a lot of you know that you can buy blank incense and create your own special aromas. And also, there's all of my books on the soaps and incense and oils because they kind of cross over and you can use them in your candles as well. And so that little shelving unit holds all of my little scrapbook papers here, because when I do tiny art, I don't need to be wasting a big giant piece of scrapbook paper. And then let's see what else is here. Just your typical sloppy little roller bin. And then my grandmother who taught me how to sew. And I took this magazine rack that I found at the Goodwill, and I put all of my drawing paper in there. And then this is just some additional tools. Oh, there's my label maker that I desperately need to put some fresh labels on some of these items. So in these boxes, the skinny boxes, I collect vintage pictures and I go to paper shows and I buy those so I can put them on my greeting cards and other things that I make. And then these are leather. And then this little wheelie cart houses more sewing items that I can just scoot on over to the sewing machine since it's on wheels. And let's look at that now that we have a bird's eye view of everything that is on the shelf. And I like that view. Yep. And Marilyn looks great up there too. So it just really does seem like my room looks bigger. And let's just take a turn here. And as Christopher Lowell always says, if you can't build out, build up. So, oh, let's look in this wheelie cart where Madame Coco is residing. So in my stage kits that I sell, I seal each bundle in its own plastic bag to keep it fresh for the user. So these are two double closets that I have here. And let's take a look before. Yelza, nothing to write home about in there. Okay, so this is some of my business stuff, papers and junk like that. And then my oversized scrapbook paper goes here. And then I also have like wrapping paper and designer paper and odd shaped items like this. I really do need to get a better shelf, I know that. But for now, that'll do. And those cedar boxes, I created a special metaphysical box for my brother for his birthday. So this is how it looks when one receives something like that. And let's continue. That's my other jewelry boxes there. And just to recap, it took me an hour to take everything out of the studio and maybe about 6 hours to put everything back in, and then 3 days to organize it. And I still need to fine tune it, but thank you for going on this journey with me and taking the time to just look at the mess I had and look what I have now. I know it was pretty chaotic there for a moment. And when you have time, please check out my Etsy shop and leave a comment if you so desire. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. So you guys be safe out there. And as always, have a happy day. Bye. Bye-bye. Bye.